In this video, we're going to be finishing the Operations with Scientific Notation worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. Picking up with number 21, we're going to take 1.91 and divide that by 5, and we're going to multiply that by 10 to the 3 minus a negative 4. And that's because since these quantities are divided and they have the same base, I'll be able to subtract the exponents. So 1.91 divided by 5 is 0.382. And that will be multiplied by 10 to the 3 minus negative 4, or 3 plus 4, which is 10 to the 7th. Now I need to take this decimal place and move it once to the right, so that I have a digit in the ones place. So that would be 3.82 times 10 to the negative 1, and I'm still multiplying that by 10 to the 7th. So that's equal to 3.82 times 10 to the negative 1 plus 7, which is a positive 6. Because those quantities are multiplied together and have the same base, I can add the exponents. Negative 1 plus 7 is a positive 6. So for number 21, 3.82 times 10 to the 6th is my solution. In number 22, I'll take 1.62 and divide that by 5.3, and then I'll multiply that by 10 to the negative 6 minus 6. 1.62 divided by 5.3 is approximately 0.3057, because it's 0.30566, which will round to 7. And I'll multiply that by 10 to the negative 6 minus 6, which is 10 to the negative 12th. Now I need to move my decimal place over once to the right. So that's 3.057 times 10 to the negative 1, and then I'm multiplying that by 10 to the negative 12. So my final solution to number 22 is 3.057 times 10 to the negative 13th, since negative 1 plus negative 12 is negative 13. In number 23, I'll take 3.59 and divide it by 2.22. And I'll be multiplying that by 10 to the negative 2 minus 1. So 3.59 divided by 2.22 is approximately 1.617. Because the number after 7 is 1, so we'll round down. And that will get multiplied by 10 to the negative 2 minus 1, which is 10 to the negative 3. And since I have a digit in my ones place, I'm in scientific notation. 1.617 times 10 to the negative 3. In number 24, I'm going to be distributing that exponent. So I'll have 8.8 to the negative 5th, and that will be multiplied by 10 to the negative 5th to the negative 5th. So my negative 5 got distributed to the 8.8 and to the 10 to the negative 5th. 8.8 to the negative 5th, when I enter that into my calculator, it won't give me the decimal, but it will give me that quantity in scientific notation, which is 1.8949, which rounds to 895, and then it says e to the negative 5, which I know is times 10 to the negative 5th. However, we need to multiply that by 10 to the negative 5th to the negative 5th, which is 10 to the negative 5 times negative 5. So that's 1.895 times 10 to the negative 5th times 10 to the negative 5 times negative 5 is a positive 25. So now I'll add negative 5 to 25 to get 1.895 times 10 to the 20th. That's my answer for number 24. For number 25, I'm dividing 6 by 8.08, and that quantity will get multiplied by 10 to the negative 3 minus a negative 2. 6 divided by 8.08 is 0.74257, which rounds to 2.6. And I'll multiply that by 10 to the negative 3 minus negative 2, which is negative 3 plus a positive 2, which is negative 1. Now I need to move my decimal place over once to the right to get to scientific notation. So I'll have 7.426 times 10 to the negative 1, because I moved my decimal place once to the right, but I still have to multiply that by 10 to the negative 1. So my final solution will be 7.426 times 10 to the negative 2. On number 26, I'll multiply 3.5 by 9. And then I'll multiply 10 to the negative 2 by 10 to the 4. But remember, since I'm multiplying quantities of the same base, I'll just add those exponents. So it'll be 10 to the negative 2 plus 4. 3.5 times 9 is 31.5, and that's multiplied by 10 to the positive 2, since negative 2 plus 4 is a positive 2. Now I still need to move my decimal place over once to the left in order to have the 3 in the ones place. So that'll be 3.15, and since I moved it once to the left, I have to multiply that by 10 to the first, and that is still multiplied by 10 squared. So my final solution will be 3.15 times 10 to the 1 plus 2, which is 10 to the 3. 3.15 times 10 to the third is my solution in number 26. In number 27, I'm taking 8.8 and I'm multiplying that by 2.25. And that will get multiplied by 10 to the 2 plus negative 2, since I can add those exponents because they have the same base. 8.8 times 2.25 is 19.8, and that's multiplied by 10 to the 2 plus negative 2, which is 10 to the 0. Now 19.8 is not in scientific notation. I need to move the decimal place once to the left. So I'll have 1.98 times 10 to the first. And I can multiply that by 10 to the 0, but 1 plus 0 is simply 1. So because 10 to the 0 is 1, I'll just have 19.8, and then I'll write 19.8 in scientific notation to give me 1.98 times 10 to the first as my solution in number 27. And lastly, for this worksheet and in this video, number 28. If you haven't done so up to this point, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated, and just let me know that you're finding these videos useful. And that, in turn, encourages me to come out with more videos for you. So go ahead and do that now, and we'll jump into number 28. I'll take 1.18 and divide that by 3, and that will be multiplied by 10 to the negative 4th minus 0. But you can think of 10 to the 0 as the whole number 1, so I'll just be multiplying that by 10 to the negative 4th. So 1.18 divided by 3 is 0.39333 repeating, so 0.3933 is what we'll round that to. And that will be multiplied by 10 to the negative 4th. However, this quantity is not in scientific notation. We need to rewrite this number, moving the decimal place over once to the right. So we'll have 3.933 times 10, moving that to the right once, will be times 10 to the negative 1, and we're still multiplying that by 10 to the negative 4th. So we'll have 3.933 times 10 to the negative 1 plus negative 4, which is negative 5. So 3.933 times 10 to the negative 5th is my last solution. If you have any questions or just want to leave me a note, put it in the comments below. And just another quick reminder, like, subscribe, and share.